yeah. Anyway, we could hop into... Oh, this week we also did a top 15 because, as we said, he's been performing for 30 years. The only other person we've done 15 for was George Strait, who's also been playing
The amount of music.
Yeah, and with our list is that we have the top 15. Me and Kevin both picked 15 songs. We only hit two songs on both lists because that's how much music he has.
Yes, like, and it's okay for Steve to be wrong.
Yeah, shut up. when I wrote down your list, just in case it made it at number 12, I wrote it down as. He has a song called Me Too. I wrote it down as hashtag Me Too. But anyway, let's just hop into the 15. If we have anything else to say, we'll just say it as we go.
I will do something.
Yes. Number 15, South of You.
I may be somewhere east of nowhere. Somewhere west of a town that's just north of an unknown latitude. I will sail a ship forever till I reach peace of mind. Live my life somewhere south of you.
This song is from one of the albums. I think it's from Clancy's Tavern, because like we said, there's a lot from that album that I really enjoy. Yeah, it's from Clancy's Tavern. And this one is just kind of words.
Yes, well played.
I'm farting right now. It's pretty much this kind of song of no matter where he goes, he's gonna be away from this girl, and it sucks in that sense. Hold on, I'm gonna look up the lyrics really quick because I'm blanking right now. South of You, Toby Keith. We prepare for this podcast. If you
debatable,
quote unquote prepare.
To be fair though, with his songs, there's so many of them, and not really listening to too much of him, you know, prior to this week or even today. There's a bunch of these songs that I like when I was putting mine together that I knew that I liked, but. I don't remember what they're about.
Yeah. But I just look at the lyrics and it just all pop out of my head. Pretty much what it is he his in a breakup with this girl, he goes, I like the chorus because it goes, I'm somewhere east of nowhere, somewhere west of a town. It's just, I'm just north of an unknown latitude. Pretty much he's out on a boat and he goes, no matter where the hell I am, I'm going to be south of you. Like, I'm down in the...
being on the bottom.
Yeah, like...
Figured it out.
It's a song about being a power bottom. Toby Keith is gay. But I just really like it because the tone of the song, you can just tell that he's heartbroken the way he sings it and everything. And Toby Keith is actually a surprisingly good singer. Recorded. I saw him I saw him at concert.
Wasn't great?
Not great. Not as bad as like Lee Bryce, but not.
Oh boy.
Not great. Hold on, I gotta get back to my list. Number 14, Beer for My Horses.
That justice is the one thing you should always find. You gotta saddle up your boys, you gotta draw a hard line. When the gun smoke settles, we'll sing a victory tune, and we'll all meet back at the local saloon. We'll raise up our glasses against evil forces, singing whiskey for my men, beer for my horses.
I just love this song.
It's a great song.
It's just one of those, like, just those Western story type ones. It's like, it's a very, like, the sound of the song isn't super classic, but, like, it's a very classic tone of, like, a country song.
It's a Western gunfighter ballad type song, and it's just about a fun song.
Yeah,
it's got Willie Nelson.
Yeah, they just talk about, like, kind of being sheriffs and bringing people to justice, and it goes, once you're done, you know, catching the criminals, you go to the bar, and it's whiskey for my men and beer for my horses, and, yeah, it's Willie Nelson with him and everything, and
a fun song, yeah.
It's just a really fun
song.
It
is a great song.
Number 13, You Shouldn't Kiss Me Like This.
You shouldn't kiss me like this. Unless you mean it like that, 'cause I'll just close my eyes and I won't know where I'm at. We'll get lost on this dance floor, spinning it round and around and around and around. They're all watching us now. They think we're falling in love. They never knew.
just wanted you to know.
It's a song I wrote for Kevin. Number 12. Number 13 is, yeah, You Shouldn't Kiss Me Like This. It's just the song about, like,
we agreed, never in the house.
God damn it. You and your Rick and Morty. it's a song about kind of being with a friend at, I think it might be a wedding or something. I can't remember exactly. But it's them talking and dancing, and then they end up kissing. And he goes, you shouldn't kiss me like that because I'm going to feel like this. And people are going to think this and that and all this. And, yeah, it's just this guy who's falling for a friend. And he goes, well, if you kiss me like this, I'm going to fall for you. And it's just a really good love song that I remember listening to it in high school. And I was just in love with the song at the time. And I still really like it because I still listen to it.
Good for you.
Good for you. Anyway, number 12, not as much of a love song. Nights I Can't Remember, Friends I'll Never Forget.
Hey, me and the boys, we made a lot of noise. And we sang all our songs for free. We parted through college, acquired some knowledge. Never did get a degree. We did it our way. Looking back on the good days, there's still not a lot.
Yeah, it's just a great song about, you know, going out and having a time and just kind of all those folks that you don't remember. Like, everybody, if you don't drink, you'd have never been in this situation. but just, you know, going out to a bar and having a great time and talking with random people that you're never going to see again and just having fun. And then, you know...
Well, it's also...
And then you're also your friend group that you go out to the bar with.
And it's kind of about being, like, grown up and looking back and remembering at the time. Like, they're all adults with families and stuff.
Exactly.
And it's just like, I just remember those nights. We were up playing music all night long. And I just love the line where it's just like, he drained every can of the cooler to try and drink that poor little pretty. Like, I love that. It's just, all these songs about just being young, being dumb, hooking up. And then also it was like... we went to school, but we never did get that degree. And all.
Yeah, I just love the combination of the, I'm never going to forget the friends, but even though all those times that we went out and we got bombed,
blackout,
I have no idea what the hell we did all those times, but I know that we had a great time and we always, we'll always cherish the memories or their, the lack thereof, and it's fun song.
Yeah, the only reason I didn't include this one on my top 15, I do love this song.
You're wrong.
Because Lee Bryce also has a song called Friends I'll Never Forget, and it's just...
Lee Bryce is garbage.
It's just kind of a generic theme, even though the message of the song itself is... I do enjoy, the song itself. It's just kind of a tired theme, but...
You're a tired theme.
Thank you. Number 11, I Love This Bar.
I love this bar. It's my kind of place. Just walking through the front door puts a big smile on my face. It ain't too far. Come as you are.
I love Lamp. I love this song because it is a song that always makes me think of up north and our favorite bar up there, and just being DJs. drunk up in Wisconsin and just putting on the jukebox and everybody just singing along to,
Toby Keith is a go-to karaoke.
Yeah, song about the bar jukebox. And everyone sings along, and it's just a great song about, him singing about the people that are in the bar and the way that the bar is and why he loves it, and it's just, if you're a person who enjoys bars, you should enjoy this song.
Yeah, it's a really good drink and sing-along song. Like, you could probably sing this karaoke and everyone would be singing along to it. Like, the only reason I didn't include this one on my top was...
Again, you're wrong.
Because I had Clancy's Tavern on mine, which I just kind of find that...
better.
What?
This is better.
No, I like Clancy's Tavern better because it's more of like a... It's like a loving the hole in the wall type bar, and you just talk about how Clancy is like the owner, and she's just a great person and everything. But I love this bar. Listen, yeah, this is on all of my drinking playlists. If it comes on, I'm super happy. And I just love the whistling part and all. Yeah, it's cool.
I don't know how to whistle.
You even got dancing girls and hookers. Yeah, mm-hmm. Like, love them.
And the veterans always talk about or show each other their battle scars. And I love the music video for this one where he's singing out like one of those honky tonks with like the cage in front of the stage. And, then it goes like the veterans talk about their battle scars, and one guy gets up, drops his pants because he has a scar on his ass. That's the other. Oh, actually, well, we'll get to it when I get it down the list. But number 10, Hurt a Lot Worse When You Go. And you lie,
like you won't say goodbye, like you do every time. Come here and kiss me and act like you miss me. Make me believe we're together.
This is one of those B-sides from mid-2000s album, I believe it was. It was from That Don't Make Me a Bad Guy, which, yeah, is a little older, but not too old. I just love this song. It's about one kind of being in love with this girl who comes over when you call her, and they hook up and everything, and he goes, well, tell me you love me before you leave, because it'll hurt a lot worse when you go, and if it hurts more, then I'll get over you by it hurting so much. And I just love, it's one of these, if you don't know, between me and Kevin's list, I chose a little more meaningful songs, where he chose the more
enjoyable songs.
Enjoyable songs, yeah. But yeah, I just, this is one of those that I heard once when going through all his albums, and I got really caught up on it, and I love it. The one I was talking about that I was going to mention with I Love This Bar is number 9, A Little Too Late.
It's a little too late, I'm a little too gone, a little too tired of this hanging on. So I'm letting go while I'm still strong enough to. Got a little too sad, I'm a little too blue. It's a little too bad, you were too good to be true. I'm big time over you, baby. It's a little too late.
I love this song because of the music video. I don't know if you've ever seen it. Like,
I don't watch music videos.
I used to all the time because they used to actually air them. But it's just like he goes into the basement and his wife is like tied to a chair and he starts building a brick wall like to block her in the basement, like hide her in the basement. And at the end, like the whole time he's singing like, it's a little too late and I'm a little too gone, like all that shit. And then the end of the song is he puts up the final brick and he's like, ha, and he turns around and he realizes he blocked himself in and she's by the stairs. And that's the thing, is like Toby Keith has a lot of dumb songs that we're like, we roll our eyes with, but he also has a really good sense of humor in a lot of his songs.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Also, it's not on our list, but As Good As I Once Was, the music video for that, where it's just like, oh, I'll help you fight this guy, and then instead he just gets decked in the face and he has to go to the hospital. And it's just like, he has a really good sense of humor about his stuff, and I do enjoy that about it. But it's funny because that music video is really funny, but A Little Too Late isn't like that like happy of a song, because it's just like this song about a girl, you know, begging him to come back. He's like, no, it's too late. Like, you fucked up and I'm gone. Like,
yeah. Like he's over her and he's not like happy about it.
Yeah.
But he's just like, no, I'm not going to fall back into this trap. But, you know, it's a little too late. Damn it.
Yeah. This is one of the two that were on both of our lists. So we were right one time.
Steve was still wrong.
Shut up. Number 8, Wish I Didn't Know Now.
I wish I didn't know now what I didn't know then. I wish I could start this whole thing over again. I'm not saying that you've ever been true. I just don't want to know how it ends.
This is the one that I didn't know when you sent it to me.
You didn't know this one.
But then I listened to it, and I was like, I definitely have heard this song, but it wasn't one that I had saved.
I was going to say, how? How?
Yeah.
I feel like this was like a big song.
Probably.
No? Yes?
Maybe not.
I have no concept of any of this. I also don't, like, going into this, like, I don't know the last time I really, like, sat down and listened to Toby Keith. He's one of those that, like, I obviously got into country music listening to him, but in the last several years, like, it went number two
back in 1994.
Yeah, so, ha. Huh. Basically 2 years after I was born, so yeah.
You were really in love back then.
Yeah, exactly. I knew. But yeah, I mean, this song's great. Great got cheated on song, and then finding out about it later, and then just kind of like having... Like,
well, I wish I didn't know this.
Exactly. Just like, I really didn't ever... Like, I wish I could never find out and just live in blissful ignorance because everything sucks and I'm in pain.
Yeah.
But I love this song.
Yeah, it is a good one. Almost as much of a good one as number 7, A Woman's Touch.
My heart needs is a woman's touch. Tender hand, a fixated look. It's rough and ragged edges. Sure good to use some love. My heart needs is a woman's touch.
This is one that I definitely heard from his 35 Biggest Hits album, and I just love this one because it's just one of those, like, a Kevin Hodge song of he's become so jagged from love that he just realizes that he just what he needs in his life is a woman's touch to make himself a little less kind of like
angry at life.
Yeah.
He wrote a song about me?
Yeah, he wrote a song right about you, Kevin.
I should ignore it and continue on jagged and jaded in life.
This song came out in... Where am I at?
What year is it?
I don't know. I don't see it. Oh,
because it never happened?
I'm in the wrong decade, that's why. It came out in 96, so he wrote about you when you were four years old.
He knew it was going to happen.
But yeah.
20 years later.
Yeah, I just really like this song because it's kind of this... It's not that he needs a woman because he's kind of, like, alone and sad that he's alone. It's just because he realizes he's become just kind of a loner, and he's just like, I just, like, a...
More like he figured out life.
Sure, Kevin. Sure.
Sure. He's really got his shit together is what it sounds like to me.
You want to know it's not a happy song? It is, I don't know why I'd use that segue because we weren't saying that. But
that was also not a happy song.
Number 6, Crying For Me, Wayman Song.
I'm gonna miss that smile. I'm gonna miss you, my friend. Even though it hurts the way it ended up, I'd do it all again. So play it sweet in heaven. 'Cause that's right where you wanna be. I'm not crying 'cause I feel so sorry for you. Crying for me.
I love this song. It's about Wayman Tisdale. I looked it up, so I'm pretty sure that's his name, but I could have fucked it up. Let's find out. He was right. Yep, Wayman Tisdale.
He was his bass player, right?
Yeah, I love the line where it says, play your upside down, left-handed, backwards bass guitar.
Yeah.
So apparently that's what he did. Yeah, he was a bass player, died of cancer, and I think it hit him really hard. Obviously, he wrote this song, and
yeah.
It's a great song.
Well,
but I just really love how he's talking about how he wouldn't want me to be sad for him. He would want me to, like, carry on and be, you know, live life. And he's like, so I'm not crying... For
because
you,
you're gone.
I'm crying for me, and the bass, like, I'm missing out on your existence now.
Yeah.
And I think it's a really sweet
that I pretty
and
much
well-written,
have to live without you.
Yeah, and I think it's just a really sweet and well written song, and it's got a saxophone in it, and
saxophones
are great.
Saxophone. I do love the I remember reading about this when it first came out, because yeah, this came out in 2009, which is pretty much when I started listening to Toby Keith, is He was going to sing this at his funeral, but he was, like, way too emotional to be able to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And so he sang just Willie Nelson's Angel Flying Too Close to the Ground instead. And I was just like, that hurts.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I do really like this song. It was really close to my top 15, and I just ended up not choosing
ended up being wrong.
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 It's wrong.
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 So wrong.
Wrong. Number five. But no, I do love the saxophone in it. It's a beautiful song. I do love saxophone. I used to play it, even though I hated band. Really, really hated band. Number five. I need to hear a country song.
Yeah, make it lonely when you do. Somebody else out there's been through with. Instead of hurting by myself, man, I will sing along. I need to hear a loser crying. Songs about love is dying. Lying, cheating to the bone. Three-chord stone cold country song.
Also from Clancy's Tavern, because, like I said, I love that fucking album. I just love this song because it's just this... He's in a shit mood at a bar, and he's just like, I need to hear a country song. I need a Stone Cold, three-chord, just depressing country song right now. And I just love the whole message of... Yeah, he's just like, It's kind of a don't rock the jukebox thing. And yeah, it's just... I need to hear a country song.
And it is a country song, yeah. Which is very nice to have actual country songs played in bars. What an idea. Music. Never seen it happen, ever.
Except for...
unless I do it.
Yeah, or if the few times we've been in like the southern bars.
Apparently everyone else has their shit figured
out. Well, remember that at Broken Saddle, the top country playlist, it has like all those old school country artists on it. We're just like, what?
Yes.
No way. But, yeah, anyway. I just love it. It's just a great, Don't Rot the Jukebox type song. And it was never a single, so it's definitely one I'd say check out because you
absolutely
probably haven't heard it.
It is a great song.
But this next one you definitely have heard because it was his first single ever.
If you haven't heard it, like, how?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love this song.
I haven't said it yet, fool.
Oh, yeah, duh.
Number four, Shoot-a-Beer-a-Cooper.
Should have been a cowboy.
Oh, okay.
I should have been a cowboy. I should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six-shooter, riding my pony on a cattle drive. Stealing a young girl's hearts. Just like Gene and Roy. Singing those campfire songs.
I love this song because obviously it's a jam and it's an old, you know, what was it, 93 when it came out, 92, yeah, whatever that
is. It was literally his first
single. So it's 90, small number, something like
93.
That. 93. Yeah. And it's just it's a jam. It's a great song. It's another one of those, you know, Western, you know, should have done all of these things and live free and all the things about that. But I also love it because it reminds me of college because we sang this in our frat house all the time.
I was going to say,
and
even though
I can't in good conscience not have it ranked high on my list because
even
of that.
Though I've heard this song a million fucking times because I, like, the first album I heard by Toby Keith was actually, I think, his Greatest Hits number 2, which they had the live version of the song on it. And I'm pretty sure, even though I've heard the song for, you know, 10 years
when
almost
it comes
now,
on, you gotta sing along.
Yeah, oh, yeah. But the what makes me think about it now is back in college when you and Jersh sang this karaoke at MD's. Because, yeah, that's what makes that. I always think of that with the song, even though I've heard it for so long. But, yeah, I do love this.
Yeah. So, although I, you know, in terms of if I was going to rank all of the songs in terms of what's, like, the best written and whatever, like, okay, I wouldn't have it as – I'd had it at, what, like, my number two or something like that. In just good conscience in terms of how much I enjoy it and what it makes me think and feel, I'd put it way high, and it's great.
It's a jam. Yeah. If you've heard Toby Keith and you listened to him before 2001 when he released Angry American, then – which is also a – Courtesy Red White Blues called. This is a great song. Number three is your number one. My list.
I cross them off as I get them done. But when the sun is set, there's still more than a few things left I haven't got to yet. Go for a walk, say a little prayer, take a deep breath of mountain air, put on my glove, play some catch. It's time that I make time for that. Wave the shore, cast a line, look up an old lost friend of mine, sit on the porch and give my girl a kiss. Start living, that's the next thing on my list.
I have loved this song as, like, my favorite Toby Keith song for a long time. Like, ever since I started listening to the 35 biggest hits, however long ago it was that I started listening to it. I just love it's the song about he's got this to-do list on his weekend of shit he's got to do, like, around the house, on the yard, go to the hardware store, all this shit that he's got to do. And he's like, you know what? Screw it. I'm going to make a new list. And it's just going to be things that are going to, like, enrich my life.
Go for a walk, say a little prayer, take a deep breath of mountain air.
All these different things is just going to make your day and your life better. And I really like that sentiment of just, you know, instead of getting caught in the menial tasks of shit you got to get done, because I got to do this, got to do that, just live life for a day and see how it makes you feel.
Yeah.
And I really dig it. And it's my favorite song for that reason.
Yeah, it's a very Time Well Wasted by Brad Paisley type song where it's just like, I have so much, like you said, I have so much shit to do, but fuck that. I'm relaxing today.
Exactly.
Yeah, it is a good one. My number one, which is our number two, is White Rose.
Now there's plywood for glass, where the windows all got smashed, and there's just a chunk of concrete where those old pumps used to stand. There's a couple of cars half out of the ground, and that old sign still spins round and round. I guess the White Rose building station's just a memory now. And the girls would spend a couple.
I'm very angry because the song's not on Spotify anymore. It's the one song by him that got taken off Spotify, and it pisses me off because this is genuinely my favorite song by him. I
had to Google it to figure out which album it was on.
Yeah, and then, Big Dog Daddy.
And then to figure out why it wasn't on Spotify.
Yeah, I don't know why it's not on Spotify. It pisses me off. All of my favorite songs are always fucking on Spotify.
Super lame.
But this song, it's just this, it's kind of one of those small towns are dying songs where it's just about this gas station that opened that had this big white rose on the sign that would spin around. And it was kind of like a lighthouse to the small town where people know that's the gas station. That's where you pull up but it says like the girls pulled up just to say hi to like the guys who were pumping the gas because they were attractive. And those girls all grew up and moved away. The highway was built over town. So now this white rose just spins over an abandoned lot pretty much. And it's just kind of talking about like, it's kind of the small towns are dying type sentiment. And I just love how it's written. I love the acoustic guitar riff in the song, and it's so fucking catchy. And I love this song so much. That's why I put it at number one.
Yeah.
But because of how we rank our list with points, our number one overall ended up being number one, God Love Her.
She's a rebel child and a preacher's daughter. She was baptized in dirty water. Her mama cried the first time they caught her with me. They knew they couldn't stop her. She holds tight me and the Bible on the back seat of my motorcycle. Left your daddy standing there preaching to the choir, you see. God love her. You're being God love her.
this song I listened to so much when it came out.
I don't know how many times I've had my windows down and just yelled, on the back seat of my motorcycle, as he sings it, because it's just a jam.
Yeah, I just, and it's, yeah, I, this was my favorite Toby Keith song for a long time until, like, I heard my White Rose. And when I started getting into more meaningful songs rather than just drinking songs, because obviously when I first listened to Toby Keith, it was like, curses, red, white, blues, the shit, like, that kind of crap. And now it's just like, yeah, it's a little
Yeah, now on to the real top 15, courtesy of the red, white, and blue, 1 through 15. Let's go.
Oh, you forgot number one, Red Solo Cup.
Oh, God. I won't even joke about that. Oh,
I was going to say before, I was going to say before this so I could play the music. But anyway, but no, God Lover, it's just this kind of Rebel Child song where it's like the girl's, you know, the daughter of a preacher, but
cliche.
But the guy that she met is like this wild child, and she's
cliche again.
And but I like it that it's not that she's like, fuck yourself, parents, I'm with fucking Billy Joe over here. It's just like, no, I love my parents and I love God, but I love this guy also. Yep. And so it's like he says, like, my wild ways are catching up to me, but she read from the Bible for me, and she's like kind of making him a better guy, even though they're still out being like a wild, you know, kind of couple.
Yeah.
She's like still grounded and teaching him kind of to be a better guy and everything. So that's why it says, like, God love her, because she's still a great person. Kevin's tattoo itches. But yeah, I just love this song, and yeah, it's always,
it is a great, it is really is great,
yeah,
and it's a jam.
Yeah, it was a single, so I'm sure if you've heard Toby Keith, you've heard that song. But
yeah,
we usually try getting like the B-sides, but occasionally, like we said, that the radio used to actually play good songs, so it's not our fault that some of his better songs are radio singles. But yeah, so yeah, Toby Keith, like, honestly, he was one of those guys. I got down to like 36 songs, and I was just like, I listen to all of these regularly that are on my, because I don't go out of my way to listen to Toby Keith alone, but so many of his songs are on my lists that I was just like, I don't know what to pick because I listen to so many of these. Like, all 15 of Kevin's, except for the one that I couldn't remember, which I didn't know now, all of them were on my top 30. Like, they were all songs that I love, that I listen to a lot, but yeah, it was
And that just goes to show that he has, you know, obviously we just went through 15 songs, but he's got a lot of good music, and it's not even like some of the other artists that we've done. Like Jason Aldean had like a chunk of albums, and then he went downhill hard. Like, Toby Keith had so many albums full of songs that even like
he was really good up to like 2011. Well,
exactly. And so there's so much music out there that we didn't even touch in this list that, like, seriously, go check out his older stuff, and honestly check out like Clancy's Tavern and some of the other newer albums, because there are good songs on it.
Like Drinks After Work, it had like Drinks After Work wasn't a fine song. It's just a good, you know, midweek, let's get a drink kind of song. I mean, also, Shut Up and Hold On was pretty shitty.
Which album is the Beers Ago song? Because I also dig that song. It's dumb.
That was from Clancy's Tavern.
Yeah, that's a dumb song, but I like it.
Yeah. No, yeah, Clancy's Tavern is a great album. Like, it has Red Solo Cup, which is fucking awesome.
To be fair, though, when that first came out, it was just like, oh, this song's dumb, but it's fun. And then they wouldn't stop playing. Yeah, but then they wouldn't stop playing.
And it became a thing that everyone just fucking, like, even I had a shirt that said Red Solo Cup, or Let's Have a Party. I don't remember what
the fuck it was. It just became overdone, and now it's like, okay, let's
It was kind of like with Dierks Bentley's Drunk on a Plane or whatever. It just became more, it just
that song's fun.
Yeah, it's fun. But it became more of like a, it wasn't like as much of people like enjoyed the song as it just became like a fucking party thing, like an anthem, where it was all of a sudden like everyone's like, Red Solo Cup, I love you. And it's the same with Drunk on a Plane, people are dressing up as like air stewardesses at his concerts and shit like that. And it was just like, it's just kind of blown out of proportion.
Yeah, exactly. They just, like, they overly commercialize it, which is a smart business.
With Red Solo Cup, though, it makes me laugh. I was thinking about it.
The video?
Well, the video is funny with all, like, the other people drinking from cups and everything. But, no, I was thinking in college, you know, remember Sing? I think your fraternity was the only one who did it.
Yeah, because we had school spirit, Steve.
We did not. We did not give a fuck.
We thought we were better than everyone,
actually,
Steve.
Well, we barely lost you in Tug of War. I still remember that. I was pissed.
Because we're better than
you. Because you had George and fucking Vic.
Because we're better than you.
America.
It's all about mass.
Also, they didn't give me a rope. I had one hand on it. It was bullshit. But
you should have planned that.
But it was funny because when that song came out, it was when we were in college, and we were going to do Red Ozo Cup. But we're like, all the lyrics we're thinking of were like, they will never let us sing this. So we just gave up, and then we never did sing.
Yeah, my favorite part of doing sing was the fact that I did not have to write any of the words or choreograph any of the movements or anything. I just had to show up, and they'd be like, say this and stand over there. And I'm like, you got it.
Yeah. Yeah, so anyway, that's, I don't really have much else to add about Toby Keith. Just, he's
been out there forever.
Yeah, he has so much more music than his memes suggest, pretty much.
Yeah.
Like, and he's also known for being like the, I want to talk about me or, how do you like me now? Like those kind of just douchey kind of dude songs. And he has a lot more good than that. And, yeah.
He's definitely worth checking out.
Yeah.
Which is why we did this whole episode.
Yeah. Like, I mean, I can...
For nothing!
Shit, I mean, I can... If anyone gave a shit, I can make just a Toby Keith list of, like, 50 really good songs by him, and it would be a good list, but...